tonight at Mackay Stadium to greet Washington State's Mike Leach. Wazoo's aerial attack only knows two speeds, fast and faster. But Nevada has its own warp speed offense. Don't blink. It's Washington State and Nevada right now.
Welcome to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Jimmy John's, as the Pack takes the field here at Mackay Stadium in Reno, Nevada, as the Pac-12 Washington State Cougars take on the Mountain West Conference's Nevada Wolfpack. So glad you could join us on this Friday night from Reno, Nevada, along with former Oregon head coach Mike Bellotti. I'm Mark Neely. Shelly Smith also with us down on the field. We'll check in with Shelly shortly. Heading now into week two of the college football season, Coach, eventually into the college football playoff, what did we learn from week one?
Well, I think we learned that Florida State escaped with a victory over Oklahoma State. Maybe Oklahoma State is better than we think. Jameis Winston looked a little rusty to me. Alabama also lackluster victory over West Virginia. Maybe it's the quarterback situation, maybe not. But I was really surprised by Texas A&M going into South Carolina, soundly defeating Steve Spurrier's squad. Kenny Hill, wow, he can play.
Well, here we are in week two, and here in Reno tonight, very exciting offenses on display. Third season now for Mike Leach as the head coach for Washington State. His version of the spread requires one thing. That's a very accurate throwing pass.
In the past, he didn't like. He loved to throw the ball all over the field.
Over 500 yards last week in their loss to Rutgers in Seattle. Nevada, Nolan Pistol Need, is not only an accurate throwing quarterback, but a quarterback that can run.
Yeah, and Cody Fajardo actually is the answer to that. Brian Pulliam wants a very physical offense that runs the ball with a mobile quarterback. Cody is soon to join the 10,000-yard club here at Nevada, joining some other great players. But he can really run. He can beat you with his feet or his arm.
And we should see him go over that 10,000 total yards of offense very early in this game. Shelly Smith, the third member of our broadcast team, down on the field with the head coach of the Pack, Brian Pulliam.
Coach, second year of this program, what is the identity you are hoping to establish?
We've got to get back to old-time Nevada football, running the ball and being very physical on both sides of the ball. And tonight's going to be a big test to see if we're getting that going that direction.
You've worked with and studied under so many great coaches, Jim Harbaugh, Kevin Sumlin, Charlie Weiss, and of course your dad, Bill Polian. And what have you learned from them?
Well, it all started with my dad, and then I've been fortunate to be with some great guys, and I've taken lessons from each guy, but the biggest lesson they've all taught me is just go be yourself. Don't try to be somebody else. So hopefully my personality's starting to reflect on this team, and we can go out and compete our tails off tonight.
You said you got your dad's temper. What are we going to see tonight?
Well, he called me about 3 hours before kickoff and told me to keep my cool. So it's the pot calling the kettle black.
All right, we know he's watching, so say hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
Hi, Bill.
Hi, Mom.
Thanks to you.
Cooler heads prevailing right now. Washington State lost last week to Rutgers. Nevada won here at home against Southern Utah. Kickoff from Reno is straight ahead. Back in Reno, Nevada. Wonderful night for football here with Washington State taking on Nevada. Nevada won the coin toss. They will receive. Nevada wearing the white. It is a whiteout here tonight. Now Washington State wearing the gray with the crimson trim. We are set to go. Washington State to kick off. Eric Powell, redshirt freshman out of Vancouver, Washington, with Kendall Brock on the left, Elijah Mitchell on the right. There's Brock, the senior from Fresno. Pac-12 Mountain West Conference matchup here in Reno tonight. Glad to have you with us on this Friday night, and we are ready to go. Mitchell decides to take it out from 2 yards deep. Using a block from Brock. Doing a lot of east-west running. Does not make it to the 20, up to about the 18, where Nevada will begin their first possession. And that brings us to the senior from Southern California, Brea, California, out of Servite High School, Cody Fajardo.
He is the embodiment of what Coach Poling wants in a quarterback, because he can beat you with his arm or his legs. He's the guy that can keep the defense honest with those pistol reads or the zone read come out of it. But he throws the ball very, very well.
Come out of the pistol. And Fajardo throwing on first down, a completion. Hassan Henderson out of bounds. Mark him out about the 26-yard line. Picks up about 8 on first down.
You love that kind of come out throwing the ball, come out aggressive, get that defense on their heels a little bit, get a second and 2 or 3 here where you can do anything you want, maybe go for the big one.
And second down and 2. Fajardo keeping it, electing not to hand off to Jackson.
That's the play right there that the Washington State coaches said they had to stop. That dart play with the fly sweep going one way and him coming up in the middle, that's the play they're scared about.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 96, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, Xavier Cooper, the defensive tackle for Washington State, called for the personal foul face mask, so a first down for Nevada. And when they mark off the penalty, it'll be a first down all the way up to the Nevada 41.
You don't want to give the underdog team momentum early, especially by your own self-inflicted wounds via penalties.
Three receivers to the near side, and officials waiting. They didn't move the chains quickly enough. Now they're ready. The officials better get ready, Mike, because it's just going to be a fast football game. Going to be a lot of plays in this one. Don Jackson is the back. Now the motion to the side of Fajardo. And a whistle at the snap. Something looked a little out of whack there.
Yeah, typically.
Offense number 72. 5-yard penalty. First down.
A little bit of excitement for Nevada Reno. Playing a Pac-12 team coming in here. But they're doing a great job. The impact players tonight, in my opinion, Jericho Richardson. 13 receptions last week for 177 yards. On the other side, Destiny Vial, he is a guy from Pago Pago, but he's the key to the Washington State defense. He's got to hold the edge and rush the quarterback.
The Vial family watching tonight in American Samoa. We say hey to them tonight, which is actually probably morning or afternoon over there tomorrow. There's a jet screen, a jet sweep to Kendall Brock. We've been anticipating that play. Nevada did not run this play in their first game against Southern Utah.
No, they saved it. But here's, and the way they run this is really unique. They toss the ball forward, so in case there's any fumble, it's an incomplete pass and you don't lose the yardage.
It was second down at 13. First possession of the game, Cody Fajardo and the Nevada Wolfpack wearing the whites. Fajardo to throw. Here comes the rush. Dangerous pass. Broken up, incomplete. That's an extra. Pushing and shoving at the end. Jeff Farrar, the cornerback, on the coverage of Hassan Henderson. They're at the 45. Incomplete pass. And then a little pushing and shoving at the end.
Watch the finish of this play. Fajardo's a little late on this. He's got a long arm motion, and that was up for grabs. These DBs are going to drive a little faster than the former opponent, Southern Utah.
Daquan Brown over there on the coverage of Henderson. So it's a third and long for the Wolfpack, a third and 13. Fajardo retreating and just slings it. Washington State is hoping for a flag for intentional grounding. No flag, but it is going to be fourth down in Nevada to punt. Destiny Vial among a big group of Washington State pressuring the quarterback.
And they talked about the fact they were fairly vanilla last week. They needed to change up the look and create a lot more pressure on the quarterback, which they did. He got just outside the tackle box, which is not a penalty for grounding the ball.
Alex Boy, a sophomore out of Long Beach, California, running for the Wolfpack. And a low punt makes a bounce to Galvin. Brought down at the 26-yard line. Malcolm Leon, special teams, making the tackle for Nevada. So pretty good starting field position after a 49-yard punt.
The speed and athleticism of a Pac-12 team should show up in special teams, because that's where some of your players should actually be better than this league. Now, Nevada Reno may not believe it yet.
And the quarterback for Washington State, get ready. He's going to air it out, Connor Halliday.
quick feet, accurate. He gets better with every rep he takes, and he can handle any type of throw. He understands defenses now, so he can feel pressure and knows when to get rid of the ball.
Last week against Rutgers, 40 for 56, 532 yards, 5 TDs, 1 pick. Quick wide receiver screen pass. Broken. Robert Lewis down the sideline has a first down. And a redshirt freshman with the catch.
That's a defensive coach's nightmare. The simple screen is just a long running play in reality, but you got to make the tackle and you got to contain. When you miss a tackle in open space, that's what you're afraid of against a team like Washington State.
First collegiate catch for Lewis. Gain of 13. Halliday coming to the near side, off the hands, incomplete. Once again, looking for Robert Lewis.
And one of the things you notice about Halliday, he catches the ball. This is truly a catch and release offense. He catches the ball and he knows where to go. That ball is gone. He's anticipating the movement. He understands where the holes are in the defense.
Two backs there, Wicks and West. We'll see how long it takes before Halliday actually hands the ball off to one of those backs. He won't be here on second and 10. He's going to take off, tumbles forward. Picks up about 4 to the 44, and a late flag comes out again, and Halliday holding his head.
I couldn't tell on that. It was a very poor attempt at a slide. It was sort of a shuffle fall, but he may have gotten hit there. We'll have to see a replay or see what happens. Let the officials figure this one out.
Brandon Cruz, our referee tonight.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense, number 9, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Matthew Lyons, the weak side linebacker, apparently came in late, but Ryan Polian does not agree with that call.
Wow. You know, I don't agree with it either. No. I don't see anything there that would constitute a personal foul. Maybe he, you know, right there, he ducked the head just a little bit. And I'll tell you what, all it is, if you make any forward motion with your helmet as a battering ram, you're going to get called.
But the question there, Coach, he really didn't slide.
No, he didn't. And you're right. It's hard, too, when a offensive player drops his helmet and shoulder pads. Right. And what are you trying to do? That's difficult. There's evidently some concern now. The officials are going to the sideline to talk to Washington State.
Now they also coming towards the sideline.
Because the trainer came out and assessed him. He has to sit out one play.
All right, so there's the explanation. So the quarterback, Halliday, must come out for a play because the trainer physically went onto the field to check on him. So that's going to bring out the backup quarterback for one play, Luke Falk.
It'll be interesting to see. I don't know that Mike Leach will change his strategy. He likes Luke Falk. He has tremendous confidence. He says he may be one of the best, if not the best, backup quarterbacks in the nation.
The first handoff. Brock Hecking bringing down Jamal Morrow. No gain on the first running play of the game for Washington State.
Wow, was there some penetration? They had timed that snap count very, very well. That Nevada Reno defensive line really got off on the snap.
So Falk back to the sideline. Halliday back in, a second and 10. Halliday. Dangerous pass, incomplete at the 25. Initially looked like Duran Workman, the strong safety, had a chance to pick that off.
And the impact players when Washington State has the ball, Vince Maley, he only cut 12 passes for 124 yards in one game last week. Great offseason, great route runner. But on the other side, Brock Hecking, you take a look at him, business in front, party in the back. He's the best pure pass rusher, power and speed that they have.
Oh, I love that hair. They have not targeted Maley yet. He's at the top of your screen on third and 10 at the 41 of Nevada. The first possession of the game here for Washington State. Across the middle and a first down catch at the 30-yard line. Jordan Dobrich tackling Robert Lewis. Lewis, who had no catches last week, has been the primary target so far.
One of the things that the Nevada Reno defense is trying to do is change the look, show green grass, and then cover it up. The problem is Connor Halliday is such a veteran quarterback, has played so much and understands defenses. He's knowing right now where to go with the ball despite the disguises. of Nevada's defense.
First down, Cougars just inside the 30-yard line of the pack. Halliday being chased and sacked. Jordan Dobrich brings him down back at the 46-yard line.
There's an example of when you can cover the receivers just long enough to get an unblocked guy. Great job of finishing the blitz, because it's not just getting there, it's making the tackle, make sure the quarterback gets down. It's also the secondary being in a position to deny the quarterback an easy throw to get rid of the ball.
Not just a sack for a loss of 15 yards. They spotted at the 44-yard line in Nevada. There's Dobrich, California native, had 80 tackles a year ago, third best on the Wolfpack defense. Coming to the near sideline, catch, Williams, Dom Williams, ran into his own man and still on his feet, but then out at the 35-yard line. Again, Jordan Dobrich, number 49. He's all over the field right now for Nevada.
Wow, and a great job of breaking tackles. They talked about Dom Williams. He only had one reception last week, but well, look at him break tackles here. I mean, that is absolutely just tough running, physical. And he finally gets down, but he makes up a good portion of that. At least this is a third manageable to get back to field goal range, if not a first down.
Yeah, he had one catch last week, but it was one catch for 64 yards. That one went for 9. Halliday pressured again, and he's sacked by Workman.
This will be an interesting call in the chess match that is defensive, deciding what you're going to go with, man or zone, what kind of pressure. Looks as if Washington State is going to punt the ball.
So that play loses 5. At 4th and 21, they bring out the punter, Jordan Descalo. Last week, he had a couple of punts, averaged 41 yards. It's Richie Turner standing back at his own 10. Scallo trying to pin him in, and a fair catch called for and taken by Turner at the 14. Both teams a punt on their first possession. Nevada takes over when we come back to Reno. Saturday afternoon football on ABC. 14th-ranked USC visiting 13th-ranked Stanford. 3:30 Eastern time, 12:30 Pacific out here on the West Coast. Stanford's won 17 straight home games. That's the longest active home winning streak in the nation. And Brian Polian, who was hired by Jim Harbaugh at Stanford,
speaks very highly of Jim Harbaugh, who instilled toughness in the program, and David Shaw, who has no ego but just continues to be a great coach. He's learned from both of them.
Second possession for Nevada, and they hand the football off. First carry, not much there for Don Jackson. No gain.
I like Don Jackson. Watching him play last week, he's got a little balance. He can make moves, but it's tougher, going to be tougher against that front of Washington State. Cooper, Pole, Vial, they're a good group.
A career high 110 yards last week with a touchdown for Jackson against Southern Utah. Hand it off again. Again, not much for Jackson. Picks up maybe a yard, yard and a half. It's going to be third and long.
They might be being patient and running the ball, because that is what Coach Pulliam wants to establish. Or it may be that one pass to the sideline scared the quarterback coach about throwing the out against this defense.
And this Cougar defense trying to force a quick three and out for the Wolfpack offense. Fajardo going deep down the near sideline. Henderson, the intended receiver, and incomplete at the 45. Daquan Brown, who's 5'11", covering the 6'5 Henderson, had solid coverage there.
But he's their best cover guy. It's thrown a little flat, and Henderson, who's got great hands as a former quarterback, he can't get that other hand over. If he'd have jumped up on top, might have a better chance to catch that ball.
So a three and out. This is a game, Coach, that we thought the offenses would be setting the pace in the tone. It's the defenses right now.
You know what? Defensive coaches and defensive players read the paper too. They're fired up. They're trying to read about these offenses. They want their name in the paper.
Alex Boyce punt a good one. Galvin lets it bounce. Actually takes a Washington State bounce back to the 42-yard line.
ESPN is your home of the new college football playoff. ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Jimmy John's Freaky Fast Delivery. And in part by Advocare. Advocare, we build champions.
Back here at Reno, no score between Washington State and Nevada with 7:28 to play in this first quarter. And so far, Coach, we've talked about the defenses setting the tone, but both teams trying to get after the quarterback.
How to change the comfort zone of the pocket for the quarterback? Get after him. Blitz, get an unblocked guy on him. Here you see number seven, Workman, coming off the edge. Great job. And that's an entire team sack as the secondary is holding off the quick throw from the quarterback.
Second possession for Washington State, beginning at their own 42 and in a crowd. The pass floated up and completed at the 40-yard line and then stood up at the 45. Jonathan McNeil with the tackle of Calvin Green, who makes his first catch tonight after two catches against Rutgers last week. But
personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, number 53, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
And that's defensive end Brock Hecking. Called for the personal foul, roughing the passer.
And he plays with a lot of emotion. You see it right here coming up the top of your screen. He's going to try to finish, and it's really, really late. I'm not sure. Yeah, he's just trying to make sure he's not comfortable. When your defensive coaches talk all week about we've got to pressure the quarterback, got to make him uncomfortable. If you get close to him, you want to hit him, you got to be careful.
Third Nevada penalty, two personal fouls. That's tipped in the air, but caught. Somehow caught by the back, Morrow.
I'm going to tell you what, Brock Hecking just made up. He tipped the ball and got in on the tackle at the same time. Amazing play. See this right here? He tips it right there. And watch him retract in space and go in, be the initial guy to hit the receiver. That's amazing energy right there.
The 18 and a half career sacks, third best in school history for the senior. Loss of three, second and 13. Hand it off, running right. This is Morrow. There's their best straight running play of the game, up to the 34, a gain of about six, tackled by Brian Lane. There's Brock Hecking. If you could see underneath the helmet, which you will momentarily, it's a bit of a Brian Bosworth Hulk Hogan hair. And there he is before the game, even sporting the sunglasses, the Dre headphones.
He is absolutely one of a kind right there.
Third and four. Incomplete. Intended for Williams. It was Evan Favors there, number 19, covering.
You know, he actually got away with it a little bit, but he didn't use his hands. He just had his body in position to stop the route from developing. You can see he stays inside, works hard. He might have got that hand in there. I'll tell you what, I think he was shielded from the officials. That could have been called.
Yeah, he definitely looked like he got away with one there. Well, they're at the spot in the field here on the 34. Well, Washington State's going to go for it.
No surprise. Like I said, neither Coach Leach nor Connor Halliday ever saw a situation they didn't want to attack.
Halliday coming down the near sideline and complete. He had a couple of receivers that had a step on their defender. That was Robert Lewis, number 15, and Christoph Williams, number 18. Nevada is going to take over on downs. It's been a defensive show so far in Reno. Cougars turned it over on downs, but Coach, they were very close to turning that fourth and four into a touchdown.
Quick look at that situation. At the top of the screen, you got two slants, but at the bottom, you got goes. And this is a choice of Halliday's fourth down and five. The heck with it. I'm going for the touchdown. And there's a speed differential there that Washington State will come back to later on.
Nevada takes over on their own 34-yard line. A scoreless game, 5:48 left in this first quarter from Reno. Jackson is the back. Fajardo hands it off. Oh, he kept it and is sacked back at the 30. Well, he should have handed that off to Jackson.
He should have, but when you get instant penetration sometimes, you're afraid of handing it off, so you just keep the ball and hope that the guy will tackle the running back. He didn't. He kept on his path to the quarterback, and that's the worst thing about the read is you get the quick penetration right there. He's not certain what to do. Held the ball. It's a big loss. Takes them behind it, out of, you know, they're behind in the chains here.
So it loses six. It's four, that is. Second down at 14, back at the 30. does give it up to Jackson this time. Makes a move to the sideline. He's out about the 35, just past the original line of scrimmage, a gain of five.
And you might say, why run the ball on that long a distance? But the reality is you're trying to get to a manageable third down, maybe get half the distance back. Now it's a little bit longer situation here, third and 10. Watch out for blitzing and some type of movement up front by the Washington State defensive line.
Third and long nine. Rana looks to the sideline for the call. Which they use signs over there, you'll see. It tells the offense to play. Fajardo, the completion at the 39 to Turner, but he's going to be tackled 2 yards shy of the first down. He picks up seven, but he's brought down there by Cyrus Cohen.
Third and long, bring medium pressure, which is not all-out pressure, but play zone behind it and make sure you tackle them short of the first down. Execution accomplished.
So Nevada to punt once again. This is Braden Sanchez to punt it. They use two punters, Boy and Sanchez. Sanchez is the left-footed punter who does the rugby punt. Third punt of the game here for Nevada, the first for Sanchez. He had one punt last week for 55 yards, and they fake it. He's got a ways to go, though, and won't make it. And Washington State takes over on the 38.
That's a great job by the defense. Coach Pullen talked to us about the idea that they could have a fake. They had a left-footed punter that ran the rugby punt. He was relying on the fact that Washington State would overload to the left because of the rugby style. They stay home on the backside. One of those risk and gambles, but it looks as if there's something going on the field here.
Looks like the flag came out after the play ended.
After the play was over. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Washington State, number 35. The penalty is in for 15 yards, and it's first and 10, Washington State.
Take a look. Normally he runs to the left. He did a mild fake, but they tried to block back on that side. Great pursuit, great awareness by the Washington State safe punt return team.
Well, what the penalty does, it's going to push the ball all the way back towards midfield.
It was a dead ball foul, so possession still changed, but it moved Washington State 15 yards back.
They're going to start actually at their own 47-yard line instead of inside the 40-yard line of Nevada.
You got to keep your cool on the road, especially early in the season.
A quick pass dropped by Isaiah Myers. They tried to set up that wide receiver screen.
And had he caught that ball, he had a lot of room to run because there was one-on-one blocking up front. The safety was 10 to 15 yards back. And that's the awareness of Connor Halliday. He's probably got that play in his pocket every single time, regardless of what the other play was called.
Myers had a nice game last week against Rutgers. Six catches for 94 yards and two TD catches. Halliday looks to the far side this time. First catch of the night for Vince Maley, but he is quickly wrapped up by Teray Calloway, the strong safety.
Great job of tackling in space. This is a one-on-one situation. It's what we call a smoke throw. If you're not covered, he's going to turn no matter what the play called in the huddle. He's going to throw it out there and let him work one-on-one. Great open field tackle.
Calloway, a redshirt freshman out of Seattle, Washington, so he's a Washington native. Cougars 1-3 so far on third down. Picked off! Headed down the sideline. And brought out of bounds at the 10. Kendall Johnson, the DB with the pick.
Great example of showing pressure and dropping out in the play zone. Take a look. Those guys now drop into coverage. That's a zone coverage. He thought he was throwing into man-to-man because he thought he had soft pressure early. Great job by the defense of disguising. Huge turnover, huge field position opportunity.
And what a play for 26, Kendall Jackson, who's a true freshman.
Lafayette, Louisiana. So the interception and return for freshman Kendall Johnson. Returned it 45 yards.
One other thing, when you're in this position, I guarantee you, coach on the sideline, Coach Pulling is talking about, guys, we've got to score a touchdown. We've got to take advantage of the opportunities. And it cannot be a field goal. We got to have a touchdown right here. Take advantage of this turnover.
Washington State and Nevada scoreless with 2:45 to play in the first quarter. An interception for the true freshman, Kendall Johnson.
Take a look right here. This is the corner, and this is the safety going over the top. Now watch as this play develops. The quarterback, Halliday, thinks that that guy's covering the outside receiver. He steps up in front, does a great job of stepping in front of the flat. Fooled the quarterback. Errant throw. Huge play and huge opportunity.
Halliday was the one that brought him out of bounds after the 45-yard return. So Nevada has a first down at the 12-yard line of Washington State, trying to take advantage of the Cougars' turnover. Jackson lowers his head for just a yard.
So far, it's been tough sledding against that Washington State defense. Those guys up front are big and physical. They're going to start to need to use Fajardo to loosen up that front to attack the flanks.
With number 98, Tony Pole with that last tackle, with 6'1", 300-pounder. And number 98. Nevada has seven rushes for minus 1 yard. They try to help that total and do so. Stumbling forward near the first down is Don Jackson.
I'll tell you what, give the coaches credit for patience. They're going to pound that middle and establish that running game. See a great job up front of a huge hole. Stabs in, and Jackson just tripped up. Might have scored on that one.
So it's third down and about a yard. And there's the Napoleon card that comes out. There's a variety of cards there to indicate the play, formation, etc. to the Nevada offense. Jackson will have the first down. Not the touchdown, but does have the first down. It'll be first and goal after a gain of two.
And that play might have been the third down and the fourth down call if they didn't get it. I don't know if there was the first down call.
No new card coming out yet there from the sideline. First and goal from the two. Jackson, running left, cuts it back. Into the end zone, touchdown Nevada. Second rushing touchdown of the year for Don Jackson, the junior out of Sacramento. And it's Nevada that scores first tonight.
Nice job, a form of student body left. You can see everybody reaching on that way. And Jackson just makes a guy miss and then just barely gets in that end zone following his offensive line. Nice job. Great job of capitalizing on the turnover, ending in a touchdown, not just a field goal.
Jackson had all four carries on that drive and puts it in the end zone. Brent Zuzo coming on for the point after.
It's raining blue and white snow in our booth all of a sudden.
Yeah. It's like the officials are going to review this to make sure he got in. Let's take another look ourselves.
Remember, it's where his knee will, where the ball is when his knee touches down or any part of his body.
Knee not down, knee down there.
What,
where's the
really
football
close.
Though?
I think the point of the football, I believe, is across or has broken the plane. Yeah.
Yeah, you see the football. It you can just barely see the stripe on the football,
yeah.
Right along the stripe
right
of the goal
there.
Line there. Yeah.
Right there. You can see it just as he goes right here. And remember, it's when his knee is down back right about there we're looking at it. Yeah, we believe it's going to be a touchdown. I don't think there's enough evidence to overrule that.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
So he said stands, not confirmed, but it was not enough, as you said, Coach, to overturn that there. So the touchdown run for Jackson.
Point after for Brent Zuzo out of the hole to Braden Sanchez. Four plays, all Jackson runs. It took up 12 yards, including this two-yard touchdown run to open the scoring tonight in Reno. 7-0 Pack with a minute 18 to play in the first quarter. It is a whiteout here tonight at Mackay Stadium in Reno. What is officially a one-yard touchdown run for Don Jackson. 7-0 Nevada with a minute 18 to play in the first quarter. The special teams is an area that the head coach in Nevada, Brian Polian, is very familiar with, and has already played a part in this game.
And he's talked about the fact that watch out on the kickoff. He may try something special. I would think on every single special teams play tonight, he's ready to pull out all stops. So just keep your eye. I don't think anything will be just business as usual. Keep your eyes peeled on what they do. They might shift. They might try to onside it. They may do a bunch of things.
Brent Zuzo kicks off, and a line drive taken at the five. Christoph Williams stood up at the 25 and tackled there. Let's check in with the studio and say hey to Chris Cotter. Chris.
Hey, Mark. Time for the Dr. Pepper Conference update. First ACC games for both BC and Pitt and Chestnut Hill earlier today. Tyler Boyd, two touchdown catches for the Panthers, but the story was James Conner. 36 carries, 214 yards and a touch. Pitt 2-0 early on the season. Mark?
Chris, appreciate that. It's fun checking out that game prior to ours here tonight. And a win for Pittsburgh. Here's 7-0 Nevada. Washington State, Halliday, a wide receiver screen in the booth. Williams up to the 33-yard line.
Once again, people like to complain about the fact that Washington State doesn't have much of a running game. That is their running game. It's just a longer handoff than usual.
That's Vince Maley, number one.
Mike Leach says he wants to put the ball in the hands of his playmakers. Doesn't matter if he hands it to him, throws it to him, laterals it to him.
Handed off to Wicks, and he's brought down for a loss back at the 30-yard line.
That was a draw play, which you would think would be a very much featured play in this Washington State attack because they throw the ball so much. It's really hard for defensive linemen who get into their pass rush moves then to motor down and play the run, but great job by that front of Nevada Reno.
Rakeem Yates getting the tackle, a loss of four, bringing up a third and six. Wazoo 1-for-4 on third down tonight. Halliday too far out of reach. Looking for Ricky Galvin. And it takes us to the end of quarter number one.
Halliday limping off just a little bit right here. You get piled up on there. He may or may not. That's not great body language when you're down by 7 points.
The only score, the touchdown by Jackson in the first quarter. Halliday limping off. We'll check on him when we get back to Reno. You're wondering how you kill time in the biggest little city in the world. Sometimes you just climb the walls.
I think I did that last night in my room. I don't know.
Well, an interesting first quarter here in Reno. Fourth down here, Washington State on to punt. Jordan DeScalo gets the high punt away. Turner takes it at his own 20. 25-30, tackled from behind at the 34-yard line. Well, ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Hampton Hotels. Virginia Tech to the Shoe to take on a ranked Ohio State Saturday night at 8 o'clock Eastern on ESPN. First ever meeting between those schools.
That'll be an interesting matchup because Virginia Tech has one of the best
defenses in the nation, and I still think...
Holding. Receiving team, number 4. 10-yard penalty. Nevada keeps the ball. Down.
I think Ohio State has still not quite figured out what their offense is going to be now.
Well, the only scoring in that first quarter... That is touchdown run, but it began with the interception by the true freshman, Kendall Johnson. So his 45-yard interception return set him up. And Jackson with the touchdown run, setting 4 plays on the drive. All runs by Jackson. Only scoring in that first quarter. So now they're marking off the hold on the punt return, and Nevada is going to begin at their own 9-yard line.
Yeah, they had decent field position, but from where the penalty occurred now, they're starting in the shadow of the goalpost almost.
James Butler is the back, 3 receivers to the right. Fajardo hands off to Butler. He finds a crease, a little jump step up to the 20. Well, this is a true freshman, James Butler, that Nevada is very high on, a run of 11.
They like him. They think he's got home run material, meaning he can touch the ball and go all the way. I'm surprised, but I'll tell you what, this doesn't surprise me as much as I say, because Polian said he wanted to establish the run. He wants an identity for his entire football program on both sides of the ball.
Right back. James Butler broke one hole, but then a hard hit at the 26. He does pick up 5. Daquan Brown applied that hit on him, and you see 11 freshmen who played last Saturday against Southern Utah, and 5 of those true freshmen, including this true freshman, James Butler.
Coach Poling said there are a couple of kids he had to get rid of, necessitating the use of freshmen if they were competent to play.
Fajardo keeps wrapped up. Looks like he has a first down, though, across the 30 to the 31 and picks up 6.
And they're pretty comfortable right now running the football. Whether they give it to the tailback, the quarterback keeps it. They're still pounding right now between the tackles, which will take its toll as the game wears on.
It is indeed a first down for Nevada at their own 31. Butler. Kept the feet moving. It does pick up a yard and a half or so, but it was a tough yard and a half.
I tell you what, he got blasted. The play came in at the end of that and just laid a knock on the pile that moved the whole thing back 2 yards.
And number 4, Daquan Brown, a sophomore out of L.A.
He's not that big, but I'll tell you what, he packs a wallet.
9 straight rushing plays for Nevada. They will not make it 10 as Fajardo puts it in the air to Richie Turner. 9 catches for Turner last week.
Again, this is a long throw, and I'll tell you what, those DBs are right in the proximity, so I would be careful making those type of throws from the hash to the opposite sideline.
To the pickup of 5, 3rd and 3, and Fajardo down the middle of the field, splits 2 defenders. Ankle tackled at the 7. And we see the wheels of the quarterback for Nevada, Cody Fajardo, right there.
And what did the coaches say? He's faster than you think. Here's the zone read, a dart play where he's going straight ahead. He splits the safeties, and nothing but a shoestring tackle saves a touchdown on the play.
Charleston White, the one who saved the touchdown, a 55-yard run for Fajardo. And a timeout called by Washington State. Well, the quarterback, Fajardo, using his legs to set up a 1st and goal when we come back. Cody Fajardo has just joined a very illustrious list. Colin Kaepernick, 14,210 yards of total offense to lead Nevada. David Neal, 11,145 in his time. And now with that 55-yard run moments ago, Cody Fajardo has just gone over 10,000 yards of total offense in his collegiate career.
Very impressive, because I'll tell you what, that's not easy to do at any level of football.
1st and goal Wolfpack at the Washington State 7. He finds the back. Butler to the sideline, hit there at about the four.
It was a nice catch by Butler, too. That was not a perfectly thrown pass. With running backs, we used to talk about hit them in the elbows, hit them really close to their body. Don't make them reach too far, but he does a great job of reaching behind him, corrals that ball, and then is just knocked out or makes the first guy miss, which is what you want to do, and then right there steps out before contact.
But did receive contact, a pretty good blow from Daquan Brown. Second and goal, under 12 minutes to play in the first half. Fajardo to the end zone! Off the hands, incomplete, tight end Matt Maughan, a true freshman, the intended receiver.
And we talked about how the Nevada offense loves the tight ends down in the red zone, the tight red zone, because they're big targets. This is just slightly overthrown. It's been a great catch, but certainly they're going to want that one over again. Defense right now is trying to figure it out. They're turning guys loose. They're not covering gaps. The defensive coordinator and D-line coach talked to them on the sideline. They need to buck up right now.
Fajardo to the end zone. Incomplete, tied up there with Sasan Henderson with the defender Brown and a late flag.
It's a big time size mismatch. Henderson 6'5". Daquan, we talked about that, 5'11", but very physical. Hard down there on a defensive back.
Pass interference. Defense, number four. Ball's placed at the 2-yard line. Automatic first down.
Intelligent choice. You want to throw that matchup. And again, I'm not sure. I think he was falling down. A little bit of a push from the defensive back. That is usually always, unfortunately, going to go against the defender.
You know, watching it in real time, I thought pass interference, but watching that replay, I didn't think so much.
I didn't either at the time. I thought he was going down, falling down on his own. He got a little help, but first and goal at the two.
He put the ball on the left hash. First and goal, Nevada. Fajardo, low snap, keeps it. Flag down, Fajardo tackled at the five. Daniel Iquale, one of those for Washington State to bring him down, but let's sort out the flag.
Somebody moved up front, I believe.
Offside. Defense. Number 97 was in the neutral zone at the snap. Half the distance to the goal. First down.
Destiny Vio lined it up in the neutral zone.
Yeah, you can see him there right there. He jumped, like I said. You get so excited down there, you know you got to make a play and you got to bring it. There's a tendency to be offsides if you're trying to jump that snap down.
So on first and goal, Butler wrapped up just outside the one.
Washington State needs to settle down. They're now not helping their cause. They're making turnovers. They're creating penalties. They've got to sit down and play some good, solid football.
Here's Tana Pritchard, number 33. That has been perfect in the red zone. 5 of 5. All touchdowns. Butler uses his blocker and walks into the end zone. Touchdown. Well, on the earlier drive, they scored on a 1-yard touchdown run. They featured Don Jackson. This time, coach, they featured James Butler with the 1-yard touchdown run to finish it off.
And they're taking control of this game on the ground, which is just what Coach Pullin talked about. He wants his teams to have that identity. Run the football. Be tough.
Rick Zuzo's point after not through. 14-0. Nevada.
See the touchdown, they pull the off guard or tackle. He does a great job of clearing through. Huge hole on the right side of that line. You and I probably could have scored on that play.
As left guard 72, Jeremy McCauley just kind of pushed McCauley in the back and said, hey, big fella, I'm coming into the end zone with you.
I'll follow your path. I could be your shadow.
So 14-0 Nevada as a true freshman, James Butler, with the second touchdown of the night for the Pack. As you look, total yards. Washington State, by the way, last week against Rutgers had a total of 6 rushing yards. You know, that's really not all that unusual for Washington State, though.
No, and let me remind you, Washington State can score in a hurry. A 2-touchdown or 2-possession deficit is really nothing to them in the first half. But certainly, I think they need to do a better job on defense. Nevada very comfortable, content to run the football and doing it with great effectiveness.
Well, Washington State started slowly offensively last week in Seattle against Rutgers. They scored just 3 points on their first 4 drives of the game, and then they scored TDs on 4 of their next 5 after that. Well, Monday Night Football kicks off the opening week of the season with a doubleheader. 17 Eastern, Giants, Lions get it going. And then around 10:20, Chargers and Cardinals. All begins with Monday Night Countdown at 5 o'clock Eastern.
You know, when Connor Halliday gets in a rhythm, he can go complete 13 or 14 passes in a row, move right down the field. So far, he's not been in rhythm. They've had to punt, lost it on downs, interception, and punt. Maybe they can change their fortunes with this possession.
And when he left the field last time, he was hobbling, but right back out there. Halliday, a bullet complete at the 42-yard line that immediately knocked out of bounds was Dom Williams.
Big target, 6'2", 190. That's that hole shot. When you have a press corner, the safety's got to cover all the way to the boundary, and they throw it in the hole about 15 to 20 yards down the field near the sideline.
That is a 17-yard pickup. Washington State can get this offense kicked into gear here.
So Lessa Ferramo saying, he did it, he moved, it was his fault.
Offside, defense, number 97 jumped into the neutral, cause a reaction by the offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Well, you calling on Celessa Ferramo. 5th Nevada penalty for 50 yards. Halliday intercepted. Workman, it deflected off the hands of Galvin. But apparently Workman is hurt. His teammates helping him up, but the athletic training crew coming out as well. Second pick tonight thrown by Halliday, but this one not his fault.
No, this is the tip drill and perfect execution. Tough result, though, with the injury.
ESPN College Football Primetime is brought to you by the Lexus GX. Dare to be spontaneous. And Dick's Sporting Goods. Visit ESPN Fan Shop powered by Dick's Sporting Goods for your officially licensed fan gear.
The stadium named after that man, John Mackey. That's his statue here on campus. That's Duran Workman walking off under his own power, which is a good sign, but he got hit right around that right knee by the helmet of Galvin after the interception. Nevada takes over. Butler broke one tackle. He's up to the 47. Let's go back to the interception coach and take a look.
It's a tip drill, but you see he does great job, Workman, of focusing on the ball, but at the same time the receiver's falling into his knee. Great concentration, but I fear that might be a serious knee injury.
I hope that's not the case, but they're working on Workman on the sideline. Second down and 3. Henderson, first down at midfield, and pushes into Cougars territory out about the 46. First down.
The continual pounding inside the tackles. The defensive players on the outside are edging in, trying to help their teammates shore up the tackles inside. That's why that play, the play action, which is what the Washington State defensive coaches fear the most, will be effective now because they've done a great job of establishing the run.
Well, that is offense, coach, seems to really have found their rhythm here.
They're really doing it. It's all about that running game.
Fajardo in the air. That almost picked off. Incomplete.
I think that ball just got away from him. You can tell when a quarterback throws a ball he doesn't like. Did you see him start to sprint as the ball was released to this sideline? He was very, very concerned. Watch him right here. He sees the ball go. He makes show in the side there, because I tell you what, he started sprinting for the sideline, worried that that might be picked off.
Darius Lamore, number 28 for Washington State, was the closest to picking that one off. Keeping it, he slides down to the 41, and I mentioned the slide because, let's face it, Fajardo's a guy who's taken a lot of punishment in his collegiate career. They need him healthy and on the field.
And he said he wants to play in every game this year, so he always knew how to slide, although he could only slide one way. He was a baseball player, but he's learned to do it much better now. And he won't always slide. It's about getting first downs, touchdown, or get down and out of bounds. So he will protect his body and protect the ball that way.
Third and six for the Pack. The 43 of Washington State. Takes the jet sweep to Brock. Throws a double coverage, incomplete at the 31. Intended for Jericho Richardson. We haven't said his name yet. Richardson, a guy who last week had a breakout game against Southern Utah. 13 catches for 177 yards.
But I'll tell you what, he had that breakout game. Washington State coaches were watching that game, and they said if there's one thing we got to do, that guy can't catch 13 passes this week.
Braden Sanchez on to punt. Ricky Galvin back at his own 10. Sanchez, who faked the last time he tried to punt, they didn't make it. That one's going to roll into the end zone. 43-yard punt will come out to the 20. 8:47 left till halftime in Reno.
ESPN is your home of the new college football playoff.
Nevada leading Washington State 14-0 here with 8:47 to play till halftime. Shelly Smith down on the field has more on the safety for Nevada, Duran Workman. Shelly?
Yeah, Duran Workman was on the bench. They had four trainers looking at him. They were manipulating his right knee as if to try to tell whether there was anything serious. He's doing some high stepping. They fitted him and put a sleeve on it. He's been on the bike. He's backpedaling on the sidelines. They say it's obviously right knee and probable return.
Probable return. That's good to hear. Thank you, Shelly.
Five was unabated to the quarterback. 5-yard penalty. First down.
I'm still not sure there's a probable return. I saw the look on the coach's face who was talking to him. It looked more like, sorry about that. Let's get healthy.
So first down and five after the Nevada penalty. There's six penalty tonight against the Wolfpack. Holiday across the middle in a first down catch for Robert Lewis up to the 36.
And Holiday has been streaky, as we've talked about. He can go on a binge where he hits 15 in a row. Will this be the start of something big for Washington State? We'll see.
Haven't said Vince Maley's name very often tonight for Washington State. He's been their big back, big wide receiver. He's at the bottom of your screen, number one. Holiday dumps it off, and with a move down the sideline goes Isaiah Myers. He's up to midfield, and another first down for Washington State, a gain of 14.
And that's great help from your wide receiver. That was a pass that traveled 2 yards beyond the line of scrimmage. He ended up making two people miss, getting a huge gain, and that's one of the things Coach Leach offense is: run after catch, make people miss, make plays in space.
Holiday hands it off. Theron West all the way to the 31-yard line, and another Wazoo first down before being tackled by Evan Favors.
They have the ability to score quick. It has usually been through the air, but they may want to take a little bit of heat off of Connor Holiday, let him relax a little bit. Maybe they'll run the ball a little bit more.
That 19-yard run for West is the longest run of the season so far for Washington State. Holiday back to the air at the 15-yard line, and another first down for Dom Williams.
He seems to be in a better rhythm. He's reading the defense. He understood what he had that time. Hit the slant on the weak side. Knew where to go with the ball.
Washington State methodically moving down the field. First down at the Nevada 13. fade to the end zone. There's a flag caught. Touchdown. Mailey with the TD. We'll see if it stands.
Somebody may have moved the line of scrimmage. It may have been the defense because they were trying to get the jump
offside.
On the stop.
Defense, number 54. The penalty is declined. Result of the play is a touchdown.
Right there inside. Tell you what, this is some explosion. That's caught on the fingertips. That is a perfect throw and a perfect catch.
So Bailey with the 14-yard touchdown reception. We've just been saying we hadn't said Vince's name very often.
He needed all 6-3, two of that frame to get that ball.
And a point after, knocked through by Eric Powell. Well, that's the Washington State offense that we've become used to seeing.
Yeah, it doesn't take them a lot of time, and it's all about rhythm. One of the things that Coach Leach talked about, he doesn't care if the defense plays man or zone. He just cares that his receivers and his quarterback both see the same thing and are on the same page.
Well, celebrating its 10th year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kick. Since 2005, Allstate has contributed more than $3.4 million in scholarship funds. Quick five-play drive gets Washington State on the board, goes 80 yards, and you look at the five plays. Mike, they went 11 yards, 16, 19, 18, and 13 for the score.
Yeah, it wasn't one of those 3 yards in a cloud of dust. It's we need something, let's make some big plays. And part of it was some missed tackles. Part of it was great recognition by Connor Halliday on the style of defense that Nevada Reno was playing.
And really a drive Washington State needed to get their offense going.
No question. They were down. When you get three scores down, there's a thing that goes off in everybody's mind that, okay, it's not the panic button, but it's pretty close. When you keep within two scores or can whittle it down to one, this is a game now.
Now the kickoff with Brock and Mitchell back deep for Nevada. Mitchell is from the one. Forward progress gets him up right around to the 20.
Tell you what, did you hear that popping? There was some hitting going on right there.
Physical.
Right close to our microphones. I love to hear that because it reminds me of being on the sidelines.
Now we'll see how the Nevada offense will respond after that quick strike right down the field for Washington State to make it a seven-point game here with 7:09 still to play in the second quarter.
You know what? I'm more interested in seeing how the Washington State defense responds now. They got to score back. Now they have to show that they can stop the run and not give up that kind of yardage to Nevada.
Great to have you with us on this Friday night college football primetime. Along with Mike Bellotti and Shelley Smith, I'm Mark Neely. Jackson tripped up, stumbles forward up to the 25 for a gain of five on first down.
I keep saying this, I like Jackson. He's a step away a couple times now from breaking it, and he's got that kind of balance and ability to break tackles.
Junior out of Sacramento, Boone Creek High School. Fajardo keeping. Maybe a yard that time.
And one of the things you saw Washington State that time, add linebackers. They weren't getting it done with their three-man front. They had to bring some pressure. And this is a run blitz type thing. They're going to put a lot of people in the box, make sure that they stop the run. But most importantly, stop Fajardo straight ahead.
Wolfpack 2 of 6 on third down tonight. Deflected, incomplete. Going for the tight end, Jared Gibson, but right there was Cachet Palacio.
They like him. They think he can play. He can cover anywhere on the field. They brought pressure to quicken the release. You see it coming off that far side. Unblocked right there. He's got to get rid of the ball, but watch this right here. This is almost a potential interception. And Cody has to get a sense of, I've got to get rid of the ball quicker. I've got to lean a little farther. The athleticism of the Washington State defense is making those passes too close.
This time it's Alex Boyd, a punt. You were wondering about the Washington State defense, how they'd respond, Coach. They did there. This low punt bounces to the 22. Galvin avoids one tackler. Been wrapped up and falls up towards the 30-yard line. And back out onto the field, bringing out the Washington State offense. Connor Halliday. That last drive was vintage Connor Halliday.
Yeah, as you talked about, he's sometimes a slow starter, but when he gets in rhythm, he just has a feel for where to go with the ball. Here, I think his receiver actually bails him out because he throws a 2-yard pass and makes a 15-yard gain, and then perfectly thrown ball to his favorite receiver, Maley, who uses all of that 6-foot, 3-inch frame to gather that one in.
Set up the pass, the screen, wide receiver to Myers. First down across the 40, up near the 45.
Too many missed tackles. You cannot allow that to happen. You have two guys that have a chance to take the guy down, and a 30-yard lateral becomes a 15-yard gain.
Hand it off tomorrow. He tried to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Interesting. They're loading the box in different ways. We talked about Nevada wanted to change up the look on defense, blitz more. They left two receivers covered by one guy to the top of the screen, loaded the box, and Washington State still ran the ball inside. So maybe he's not as aware sometimes as I think of the defense.
A little behind Myers, who had to adjust to make the catch at the 47 of Nevada, a couple of yards shy of the first down.
They brought a blitz from that side of the field. We can see this right there. That leaves two receivers on one. Great job by the quarterback throwing the ball. Not quite on rhythm, though. Forces a very short third down, but against Washington State, you better watch out, because last time they had a fourth and short, they threw deep.
Looking at a 3rd and 2 here, 1 of 5 on third down so far. Maley lowered the shoulder, and it looks like he does have the first down. You mentioned the 6'3 he used on that touchdown catch. He used the 220 as a 220 pounds there to get the first down.
Absolutely. And this is a standard play in this offense: block the outside guy one-on-one, and we're expecting him to either make the guy miss or to overpower him for that 2-yard gain.
With 4 minutes to play in the first half, a first down for the Cougars to the far side. The completion once again to Isaiah Myers. Looks like he has the first down at about the 33-yard line, tackled by Evan Favors.
And I think we could say Halliday's got in rhythm.
This is kind of how it went last week for them against Rutgers. First 4 or 5 drives, they really scuffled. And then their next 5 drives, 4 touchdowns on 4 of the 5. Halliday going towards the end zone, incomplete. Was leading the receiver towards the end zone. And Nigel Hakins coming over to defend Morrow.
He's throwing to a hole in the zone. You can see him, he stands in there, gets bumped a little bit, but he's already predetermined. He's thrown to that spot, to green grass, as they say, and just slightly overthrown, but great anticipation by Halliday.
Robert Lewis, the intended receiver there, he's been a frequent target tonight. This one dropped at the 20. By Dom Williams.
Yeah, it may have been tipped. Jonathan Beal might have got just a pinky on this. Let's take a look, because usually receiver will catch that. Yeah, he did. That ball changed on him. That receiver was frustrated because he thought he had a chance to catch it. Great job by McNeil getting under that rock.
Halliday had completed 8 straight passes before that last misfire. Finds Maley down the sideline. And Maley has the first down for Washington State, run out by Nigel Hakins.
I would have liked to seen a fourth down, because I believe they would have gone for it. Didn't have to worry about it now.
got to tackle in space. Another same thing. The receivers have to be good blockers. They have to occupy the defenders. If you can get them on the ground, that's even better.
First down, Washington State at the Nevada 16. Halliday right along the sideline to Dom Williams.
Very comfortable getting a similar coverage to the three receivers to the wide side of the field. They're playing off on the outside. This is an easy throw, just a timing throw. Receiver waits for the ball, taps his feet down inbounds, gets over the first down mark. They're going to throw that all night long unless they change the look on the widest receiver to the wide side of the field.
So Myers there, get the left foot down right at the six. First and goal in a timeout called by Nevada. So Washington State trying to bring in the game tying score with 2:48 left in the first half. Well, the Cougar fans were concerned when Nevada got out to the 14-0 lead. Maybe they're breathing a little easier these last couple of drives, and more looked like vintage Connor Halliday in the Washington State offense.
He's caught fire, but they got to finish this drive.
And they have a first and goal from the six. Handed off, Wicks. Stopped at the three for a gain of three. Big hit by Matthew Lyons.
Combination tackle, that's a nice tackle though in the open field, because that's really hard to do when the running back has a two-way go. A
couple late subs come in, a couple of tight ends. Washington State, a little mishap on the snap, but a whistle right at the snap.
False start, offense, number 58. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Well, the play looked like he wanted the jump ball to Williams, Dom Williams. But instead, it's Washington State's fifth penalty of the night. It's going to push him back.
They're not helping themselves in that regard. I would say that you have to be better than the other team in their stadium, especially with penalties, because it's not the officials, it's the crowd noise that can affect them.
Second and goal, back to the eight. Halliday again looking to the near side. Well, he was wanting Dom Williams. At that time, they had a couple of defenders over in that area right near the goal line, including Charles Garrett, number 24, the cornerback.
If the Nevada defense can hold Washington State to a field goal attempt, that's obviously a form of a victory. It's a moral victory, maybe points, but they certainly do not want to give up a touchdown.
Mainly on the sidelines. It is third down and goal from the eight play. Halliday towards the back of the end zone, contact and a flag. Williams was bumped by the aforementioned Garrett, and it's going to be first and goal again.
It'll be interesting to see what they call here, because I'm not sure that pass was catchable. They might call defensive holding as opposed to pass interference. Let's see what the call is. There's no way that pass was catchable. Yeah, see that signal? That's what Coach Polian's saying, the same thing.
There was no foul for defensive pass interference. The ball was uncatchable. Fourth down.
You're right on it.
Well, I would have been yelling the same thing if I was a coach out there, so. It has to be, in order to be pass interference, the ball must catch it. I think they could have called defensive holding, though, no question, because he grabs the guy right there. So, I'm surprised they didn't call holding.
So the drive stalls, and on fourth down, Eric Powell wants to attempt a 25-yard field goal. He hit a 22-yarder last week against Rutgers and missed from 50. Went 1-for-2 a week ago. Sneaks it inside that right upright. and makes it a 14-10 game. But the good news for Washington State is that their quarterback, Connor Halliday, has 138 passing yards in this second quarter alone. The good news for Nevada's defense, they held him to 3 instead of 7.
Exactly right. When you can hold a team out of the end zone, when they got first and goal from the 7, that's a victory.
Whiteouts here at Mackay Stadium in Reno, Nevada. You know, there has been a Pac-12 team come here to Reno and gotten beat recently. Cal, I'll say recently, back in 2010. And then Nevada went to Cal to open up the season 2 years ago in 2012 and won in Berkeley.
Yeah, they spoiled the debut of the new stadium. That was not much fun for Jeff Chedford and company.
Brock and Mitchell back deep for Nevada with still a minute 54 to play in this first half. One timeout for Nevada.
Let's see what Nevada does. Since they have the lead, I'd be curious. If they get good field position, I would expect them to go into a two-minute offense. If they get bad field position or don't get something, they may be comfortable running out the clock having the lead. We'll see what Coach Bowling's made of and how aggressive he'll be at the end of this half.
From the goal line, Mitchell. To about the 22. Let's check in with the studio once again. Here's Chris Cotter.
Mark, coming up at the half, Mark May will join me. We'll take a look at the big Pac-12 games this weekend. Actually, could be a Big Ten weekend if all goes right for that conference. We'll also talk about picks, all those games, all the major games, and also Mark May will make those picks. And speaking of May Day, his alma mater had a great game earlier today. Pitt and Boston College. We'll show you highlights of that one coming up at the half. Mark?
Looking forward to that. Thanks, Chris. A big weekend at college football. Michigan State, Oregon, of course, USC and Stanford. Let's see how Nevada plays this with a timeout in a minute 49 to go in the first half. Keeper Fajardo weaves his way through traffic. A gain of about 8 on first down.
I'd say with that, they're always in no huddle, but the reality is now you also have to save time when you can, which means get a first down, get out of bounds, or whenever you can to stop the clock. They move fast enough. They have good field position now. But what they'd like to do is take it down and score and leave no time left on the clock for Washington State.
Hand it off to Jackson, who has a touchdown run in this half. And he has the first down up near the 35. You know, we should also mention what the clap is. Fajardo will clap, which is basically setting up, what, a silent count?
Yeah, it alerts the center and the offensive line that now he's ready, the backs are in position, whatever motion or shifting is taking place is already done, so that now the center can snap the ball when he sees fit, and he can keep his eyes on the defense.
And the center, Gallus, can keep that head up. Fajardo kept it, but staying home was Ivan McClennan. We have Washington State has a couple of timeouts.
And they just called one because they want the ball back. You get a stop like that, which puts Nevada way behind the chains now. They're going to hope to get this ball back with a little bit of time left. And Nevada, obviously, with that type of a running play, taking that loss, is very comfortable trying to run out the clock with this lead.
So a loss of 3 after the tackle by McClennan. 45 seconds left. Each team, one timeout remaining, and a 2nd and 13 upcoming for Nevada.
Be interesting to see, and this will tell us for sure, because if they throw the ball here and attempting to get a first down, we'll know that they want to score. If they run the ball, then they're going to be content, I believe, to run the clock out.
Mizzou Toledo coming up noon Eastern time on ESPN. OU's making a short trip up to Tulsa, Akron, and Penn State. Some of the upcoming games, the ESPN networks.
Christian Hackenberg, a great young quarterback at Penn State. He's going to be really, really good. He's one of those guys to keep an eye on for the future, and the future is now.
Now he's taking a knee.
Yeah, take a knee formation. I won't fire the crowd up in the right way at this point.
Smart thing to do.
He can let the play clock run down. It's only about a 2 second differential. So if he runs backwards for a couple of seconds and
we used to practice that play. Take the snap, retreat, and let the time run off the clock and then take a knee.
Now he takes a knee, but the Lions doing some pushing and shoving. And we have come to the end of the first half here in Reno with Nevada owning a 14-10 lead over Washington State.
Yeah, interesting. I think if you're the underdog and you have the lead and you don't want to risk giving the ball back to a team that's just scored the last two times they touched the ball, I understand that.
Shelley's down on the field with Coach Polian. And Shelley.
All right, Coach. Connor Halliday and the offense seem to be figuring something out. What do you need to do defensively to change that?
They've sped up a little bit. We need to keep up. We got to stop it with the penalties. We've kept them alive on some drives with some dumb penalties, and we need to tackle. What they're doing right now is not earth-shattering stuff. We need to tackle in space.
And what if they start figuring out how to stop the run?
Well, then that's their challenge. We're gonna figure out how to keep running it, and when the time comes, we'll take our shots. Look, we by no means did we play a perfect half. We're up. We got a long way to go, and we're gonna go get our guys ready for the challenge.
Great. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Well, you mentioned, Mike, some poor tackling hurt Nevada, and Coach Polian mentioned that as well. Well, Nevada scored the first 14 points of the half. Washington State the final 10. Nevada leads it by 4 here at the intermission. We'll send you to the studio for the halftime report. Get it back in Reno, ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Jimmy John's. All ready to start the second half in Reno. Nevada scored the game's first 14 points. Washington State the last 10 of the first half. It's a four-point game as we start the third quarter. A whiteout here at Mackay Stadium in Reno. Great to have you with us along with Shelley Smith. Former Oregon head coach Mike Bellotti, I'm Mark Neely. Nevada to kick to begin the half. Brent Zuzo to kick off with Ricky Galvin, Christoph Williams. All back deep. Scooped up at the 5. Ricks still on his feet. Up to the 30. What were your impressions, Coach, of the first half?
Well, I thought both teams committed too many penalties. They're both on track for double-digit penalties, which will hurt you. For Nevada, the key is tackling. For Washington State, it's about eliminating turnovers.
Well, both teams kind of struggled offensively early, but Fajardo really got things going offensively for Nevada with his 55-yard run. Helped set up a score. They got out to the 14-0 lead, and then it was the Washington State offense that found its rhythm. Halliday had a big second quarter. After a couple of picks, he did find Vince Maley for a score, and it's Washington State with the first possession of the second half. Galvin wrapped up and thrown down at the 40, but not before he picks up 9. It's picked up more from down at field level. Once again, here's Shelley Smith.
Connor Halliday got hit pretty hard in that first half, and Brian Polian told us this week that he becomes a different player when he's hit hard like that. And Mike Leach admitted as much, saying he needs to settle down. That's what we need to do. And you know, Leach, not a man of many words. He just said, we've just got to play better.
Thanks, Shelley. Penalty flag there on the false start.
Offense, number 63, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Gunnar Eklund moved early for Washington State. Yeah, Mike Leach is sometimes a man of few words. When you get him on a topic that he enjoys, he
He can be very articulate.
Yeah, you want to talk about Geronimo, stand back. He'll talk with you for a while.
So. He wrote a book about Geronimo. It came out this past spring. Halliday now flushed. And he's going to step out back at the 32.
You know, we talked about overall in that first half, he had two interceptions and two sacks. Did a nice job there, but I would love to have seen him throw the ball away just to save yardage.
As a result, he loses 4 yards.
He's not the most mobile guy. He's not going to use his feet. He's got to use his eyes, his brain, and his arm to lead his team.
These are the first half numbers for Halliday. First 5 drives, and it came alive on the last two. Hands it off. Morrow, first down. Up to 49, close to a first down. It's going to leave him about 2 yards short. He had a pretty good head of steam initially coming through the line.
The draw play is a great play against a team that wants to try to rush the quarterback because they get in a pass rush mode. They don't think about canceling the running game, and it sets up the lineman can just ride them by. Big success for Washington State running the ball with the draw.
Gain 17, third and 2.
I guess they're going to throw it. They've got single coverage on the outside.
Going deep down the sideline, a little push and incomplete at the 25. Well, wow. Brought in at the 19 by Dom Williams.
I'll tell you what, this is great coverage. Does a nice job, as good as he can be right there. Doesn't know where the ball is. Great job by the wide receiver finding it coming through the defender's arms. Perfectly thrown pass. As I said, there's no fear on their part about throwing to a covered receiver.
Great look there from our crew. That was the best angle. Definitely caught a gain of 32. West, hard hit. Penalty flag.
Holding, offense number 73, 10-yard penalty, first down.
And it's coming back after a hold by the right guard, Eduardo Middleton. Thought it was interesting, Mike. You look at the first half, each offense ran 39 plays, and this tells you really the personality of each. Washington State passed it on 30 of their 39 plays in the half. Nevada ran it on 26 of their 39 plays in the half.
And I think it's also what they felt they could do best against these respective defenses.
So the Cougars behind the chains here, first and 20, ball back to the 29. He was looking for Morrow, instead floats it towards Maley's direction at the 20, but incomplete coverage there. Once again by the freshman Kendall Johnson, who had the interception earlier tonight.
Got a little bit surprised, thought he had an easy throw into the strong side flat to the multiple receiver side, came back, and luckily though, had the presence of mind to throw it away, save the down and distance.
There's three receivers up top. Looking in that direction, instead dumps it off Williams. Across the 20. Back near the original line of scrimmage, stopped by the weak side linebacker Matthew Lyons, a gain of 9.
Good crossing route, good patience by Halliday. He waited for the receiver to come open. It was a zone defense. Now he cut down. Now they're semi-manageable, 3rd and 10. And the real key is, Leach would tell his quarterback is, what are they doing? Is it man or zone? Don't worry about who threw it to yet, but read the coverage and throw the open guy.
Tom Williams down there at the bottom of your screen. It's done, the pass over the middle, incomplete. Looked like the receiver already lost his footing. Evan Favors, as well as Jordan Dobrich on the coverage, and it's 4th down.
Looks like the field goal team coming on. Watch out for fakes down here in scoring territory on the road. You got to be willing to take chances.
Well, Eric Powell hit from 25 earlier. This is a 37-yard attempt. Now the hold of River Craycraft. Near that upright, but missed it right. So the drive stalls in the 35-yard attempt, and Washington State comes up empty. Glad to have you with us behind the wheel. And hey, the last race left to qualify for the chase for the Cup is this Saturday. Just two berths remaining. NASCAR Sprint Cup Series in Richmond, presented by AutoZone. Coverage starts on ABC Saturday at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific time. Here in Reno tonight, Pac-12 Mountain West Conference matchup. First possession of the second half for Nevada. Not much there for running back Don Jackson.
And it would be interesting to see if they stick to the running game, which they had the most success with in the first half. But it also, what's the response from the Washington State defense? They know they got gassed by the running game. They've got to play tougher up front.
Give to Jackson again, who falls forward to the 22. And just to pick up a two. And just like that, it's going to be third down and 8 for Nevada.
Yeah, they didn't hope. By two runs, they have been averaging about 4 yards a carry that way. They didn't expect to be 3rd and 8. They thought they'd be 3rd and 2. So the reality is they're probably going to have to do some type of a play that gets Fajardo on the edge or gives him a chance to throw the ball with good protection.
Richardson, the receiver, at the bottom of your screen. Pump fake it in that direction. Slinks it out to Hassan Henderson, where he steps out. He is going to be short of the first down.
Had a chance. They were trying to run the pump screen and go. So they're trying to draw the secondary by faking the screen. They had a guy running deep. He got held up, didn't quite make it. So they took the easy throw. Good choice by Fajardo, because it was a play that had a chance still to gain the necessary yardage.
So out comes Alex Boyd to punt, 5th Nevada punt of the game.
Now this is Washington State's punt return team. It's only 4th and 5. Watch out for a fake. This would be a great time to do it.
And a gutsy call. Boyd boots it away. End over end punt. Taking a Nevada bounce all the way inside the 20. Down there by Malcolm Lee. Nice punt by Boyd to pin him in inside their 20. A 57-yard punt. Well, our Friday focus, game day is in Eugene. Saturday, 9 a.m. Eastern time tomorrow morning. And, of course, Virginia Tech is visiting number 8, Ohio State. Fun weekend of college football ahead with Stanford hosting USC. Part of our Friday focus, getting you ready for this weekend in college football. Stanford's won 17 consecutive at home, longest active winning home streak in the nation.
David Shaw done a tremendous job there as coach.
Dumped off underneath. And the tackle, Dom Williams, brought down by Jonathan McNeil, the middle linebacker, with some authority.
Well, that was a great wrap-up. That was a, hey, here I am, face-to-face, I'm taking you down. That's a great wrap-up. Take him down, roll him to the ground. No chance of breaking that tackle.
Well, the coaches for Nevada told us, hey, McNeil is our best tackler. Short gain at just 1, 2nd and 9. Holiday's pass right into the arms of Robert Lewis, but Brian Lane Jr. wrapped him up, a gain of 5.
And the one thing that Connor Halliday is looking across the field to see who's got off coverage. Do I have somebody that's off more than 5 yards from a receiver? I'm going to go there, or I'm going to end up with the guy, whoever takes his place, I'm going to find that hole in the defense. A couple people playing off, I would guess they're going to come up, or they're going to challenge that first down marker.
Halliday eluding one tackler, but not able to avoid a second and a third, and lost yardage. Again, thanks to Jonathan McNeil.
Defenses love to say, make them get rid of the ball, throw it underneath, let's rally to the ball and tackle him short of the first down marker. You saw the first guy miss, but you saw guys 2, 3, 4, and 5 finish the job. That's great defensive pursuit.
Scallo punting. 4th Washington State punt. Richie Turner back at the 30. So a three and out for Nevada, followed by a three and out for Washington State. It's a short punt. It's going to bounce at the 45, but take a Washington State roll inside the 35. 14-10 from ESPN College Football Primetime, sponsored by Jimmy John's.
ESPN College Football Primetime is brought to you by the United States Marine Corps, the few, the proud, the Marines, and Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
Well, thanks for staying up with us from Reno, Nevada. College Football Primetime. Washington State and Nevada, 14-10, Pack leading. There's still just about 8 minutes to go in this third quarter. The Nevada team with possession at their own 33.
You think we'd have a defensive struggle like this?
No, this has not gone, I don't think, the way either of us thought, but it's the beauty of college football. Nice run, James Butler, to the 41 for a gain of about 8 on first down. This freshman, true freshman, James Butler, one really liked by the Nevada's coaching staff, but this may come back with a penalty flag down.
After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, offense, number 65. 15-yard penalty, the down counts. It's second down.
Wow, that's Matt Gallis, who's the center. Well, he's a Remington Trophy watch list center this year.
He's a warrior and he's a leader. And I think that just that last shove at the end after the whistle blown, a little bit too much for the officials. They're trying to get the big play. Nevada has only had two plays of over 10 yards tonight. One was Fajardo's 55-yard run. So they've got to get this offense on track a little bit. It's hard to drive the ball. You've got to get some big plays.
Hassan Henderson to the 39. Pickup of a dozen.
He's a big target to start with at 6'5", but he goes up in the air and snags this ball. That's what you love about a wide receiver that would do that going over the middle.
Nevada picking up the tempo, trying to find the tight end there, Jared Gibson, but incomplete. And it's fourth down.
And they're sneaky with their tempo. They're not a warp speed team. They vary the tempo to try and catch a defense off guard. Great play call, just couldn't quite execute that time. Same thing, I keep talking about when the punt return team comes on the field and it's only fourth and five, I'd fake it.
I don't care. Sanchez to punt. Galvin's back at his own 15. And the left footed punter gets it away. It's going to bounce out of bounds right about the 30-yard line. So not a very long punt that time from Sanchez, just 33 yards.
And they kick it that way to really avoid returns. They use the semi-rugby style. He can go to the left. They're typically not going to kick it high in the air, but they try to drive it 35 to 40 yards and out of bounds. So they limit the returns, which I can understand. You don't want to put it in the hands of the punt returner, who typically is one of the best athletes and most dangerous return men on the field.
So just a shade under 7 minutes to go in this third quarter. Back comes Connor Halliday and the Cougars offense.
They caught fire at the end of the first half, but they've been waiting to catch fire again this half.
Halliday flushed out, hangs on to it, runs out of bounds. Lenny Jones was the one chasing along with Brock Hecking.
He just got restricted.
Great job of pressuring the pocket, and then the secondary for Nevada did a great job of passing off receivers. As they changed levels, they stayed with them, passed them off very, very well, which didn't allow Halliday anywhere to go with the ball.
He lost 2 yards on that when he stepped out.
Typically in this situation, you want to get back half of this distance. Get 6 to 8 yards so you have a manageable third down.
Slings it out to Maley. Uses the blocking. And has a first down up at the 41-yard line. That little wide receiver screen with the big body of Maley has been a productive play.
Or you get great blocks by the two wide receivers out there that take
the defender's out of it. You run through a tackle, and you get the first down. That's Washington State's running game right there.
Gain of 14, first down, Cougars. Quick strike to the 48-yard line.
I'm going to add, in addition to tackling, Nevada has to focus on shedding blocks on the outside. They're getting hung up. The receivers for Washington State are doing a great job of tying up the would-be tacklers on the quick screens.
To gain a 6, 2nd and 4 to the catch by Drew Loftus. Handed off tomorrow, straight ahead to midfield. Close to another first down after a gain of 3.
That was great push by Washington State's offensive line. They had a full-on 5, 6, or 7-man blitz coming, filling all the gaps. They still got pushed and almost made the first down on that play. Third short. Now, this is not a rundown necessarily in Washington State's offense. A run situation, excuse me.
Morrow is the back. They do hand it to him, and he goes straight ahead. They push it back, but forward progress. He'll have the first down and picked up 2. But as you said, Coach, you know, it's no gimme run play on 3rd and 1 for Washington State.
No, but this offensive line now is bigger. They used to not run because they were light up in the front end. They didn't have the kind of muscle to move people. Now they're 300, 318, 320, 305, 305. They're big enough to push people around.
Halliday across the middle to the 38-yard line. Robert Lewis tackled by Jonathan McNeil.
Nice job by Halliday. Great protection in the pocket. See him going 1, 2, 3 with his reads. Find the guy eventually over the middle. He pump fake to the outside to freeze people. Great job of moving with his eyes first. Let his eyes lead the throw.
Picked up 9, 2nd and 1. A lot of things Washington State could do right here.
Absolutely. They're continually been ahead of the chains after that first play in this drive.
And Halliday fires! Completion inside the 20-yard line, and another first down for Robert Lewis.
I don't know if there's a better team in the nation at throwing the vertical seam passing game. And Connor Halliday very comfortable throwing that ball over the underneath coverage of linebackers in the vertical seams created between the safeties.
5th catch tonight for Robert Lewis. Actually, his 6th catch for 71 yards. Halliday looked right, runs left, just slings it out of bounds.
He's got linemen way downfield. I don't know if that's the call. There's a penalty flag down, but he threw the ball.
Holding offense, number 63, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Called the left guard Gunnar Eklund for the hold.
I'm not sure if that was going to be a quarterback draw of some type. He pump faked and started to run ahead and just threw the ball away. And I think it was because a guy took a different path and cut off the quarterback draw.
Halliday had been 4 for 4 on this drive, 51 yards. Both teams have been penalized heavily. Dom Williams. You know, in this offense, if you're a wide receiver and you don't block,
you don't
have a role.
Yeah, because if you block for me, I'll block for you. And if you're one of those guys that doesn't block very well, then you're probably not going to play very much. That was great pursuit by Nevada's defense, because that's how you also have to stop that wide screen, is get more people there, get them there in a hurry.
They're playing behind the chains after a holding call. Already 5 for 5 on this drive, trying to make it 6 for 6 and can't do so at the 10-yard line. A leaping attempt by Maley, covered there by Teray Calloway, the strong safety.
This will be an interesting situation. Third and approximately 20 or whatever. You've got to throw the ball either in a seam, unless he feels man-to-man. You can have the crossing routes underneath and allow the guy to run for the first down. So typically, Nevada may determine where this ball goes based on what coverage they play.
Bailey, the receiver at the bottom of your screen. Halliday has to make a decision. At the 24-yard line, only one tackle, Lewis. And then out at about the 20. Eighth catch tonight for Robert Lewis. So fourth down. Eric Powell, who missed a 35-yarder earlier in this half. In fact, first possession of the half for the Cougars.
We're going to give him a chance to atone right here.
It's a little bit longer attempt. 38 yards. And it's almost a replay of the first. Wide right. Looks like Mike Leach was trying to get a timeout before the kick, but didn't get it. He wants an explanation. So the 38-yard field goal missed by Powell, and again, Washington State comes up empty. Stanford puts the nation's longest home winning streak on the line on Saturday. College football on ABC, 14th-ranked USC, 13th-ranked Stanford. 3:30 Eastern time, 12:30 Pacific. USC with 105 plays they ran against Fresno State last Saturday. Don't think they're going to run 105 in Palo Alto.
No, although Stanford's not quite the same team. They're a passing team now. Ty Montgomery has emerged, just as the running game for Nevada may have reemerged.
Ron Jackson with a 19-yard pickup. And a first down up to the 39-yard line. Fajardo keeping. A drop for a loss. Back at the 37. And Taylor Taliulu.
And he knew he was stuck that time. That was almost like a slide. He was going to go down, avoid letting the first guy hit him. Second guy tried to get the ball. Smart decision.
Lost a yard. Second and 11. Fajardo keeping. Back to the line of scrimmage. Washington State's defense doing a better job against Fajardo, at least Fajardo's running attempts.
You know, when your opponent has missed two straight field goals, you feel like you've dodged a bullet, but you also feel like you need to show up on offense. You need to do a little bit here. Halliday versus Fajardo, you know, the rushing numbers don't say anything, the passing numbers don't say anything. Nevada has to get on track offensively, needs a drive, because Washington State probably should be ahead in this game right now. Two fairly makeable field goals.
They have missed 35 and 38 yard attempts here in the third quarter. Fajardo. First down. Hassan Henderson to the 40 of Washington State.
He got man coverage on the backside, one-on-one. This is a throw. This skinny post, he can throw this. He loves to throw it right on line. Drilled it in there.
22-yard gain. It looks like a timeout has been called.
Out. Washington, their first of the half. Timeout on the field.
So Washington State uses their first timeout. We'll step aside as well with 1:16 to play in the third quarter.
ESPN is your home of the new college football playoff.
From Reno, ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Jimmy Johns. Along with Shelly Smith and Mike Pilotti, I'm Mark Neely. 14-10, Nevada leading Washington State. And it looked like after that 22-yard pass completion, Nevada coach was going to kick up the tempo and may have caught the Cougars by surprise. Jackson off left tackle for a gain of two.
Yeah, they're sneaky when they accelerate that tempo. They want to use it after a first down or on a second down prior to a third down so they can create the matchups they want and not allow the other team to substitute.
Minute to play in this third quarter. Jackson. Be about a yard short of the first down. And runs there for seven.
Very patient runner. If you notice, he took off, sort of stopped, started, saw the hole inside, cut back, and then used his power to almost get the first down. I like the way he runs.
That's a touchdown run tonight, a one-yard TD run that actually opened the scoring. Right back to him for the first down. Head to the 27 to move the chains.
They've rediscovered the energy necessary to create some holes and some movement up front. And I think they're going to continue to do that because that has been their bread and butter all night long.
Right back. So the tempo, will they get the playoff? That's Butler. To the 23, and that's the final play of this third quarter. No scoring in the third quarter, though Washington State missed a couple of field goal attempts. Well, they don't get Pac-12 teams to come to Reno all that often. And we begin the fourth quarter, Nevada leading Washington State 14-10. ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Jimmy John's. Okay, you're not Johnny Football, but maybe you can make SportsCenter. First play of the fourth quarter. Fajardo keeping! Sidestep to the defender, but then tumbles down at the 12-yard line. If he'd been able to stay on his feet, he may have scored.
Great job. They ran the read play on the inside tackle. They turned loose the guy inside, and then he tackled the running back. Fajardo pulled the ball. Huge hole. Made the most of it.
Well, first down at the 12 of Washington State. You just get the feeling, Mike, that Nevada has to score at some point. I don't think 14 points is going to win this football game for them.
I agree. And I think they need touchdowns, not field goals. Although any kind of points here is good because it would make it at least a full touchdown possession ball game. They got to score, though. You cannot miss. You can't afford to pass up opportunities to score. One of the things that they talked about from an offensive standpoint was they needed to score touchdowns in the red zone. So far, they have.
Richardson, the receiver at the bottom of your screen. He had 13 catches last week against Southern Utah. Has not caught a ball yet tonight. Falling forward, Butler. It's going to bring up third down. And a long four. Make it five. As Richardson's numbers last week. 177 yards on those 13 catches. Washington State has kept him quiet.
No offense to him. That may be a product of who they played and the style of defense. He got some easy throws by deficiencies, I believe, in the defense. But this will be an interesting down. Fourth and a long, four, short 5 yards. All plays are open. Well, it's not going to be that now. We're going to have a third and long. And I think they could have had.
Offense, number 72. 5 yard penalty, third down.
Either a run or a pass on there. I think they trust their offense enough to get 4.5 yards. But the reality is now, I believe they have to throw the ball. I would move the pocket because I think Fajardo, buy him a little bit of time, let his receivers work. They may do a token play action, but I think they'll move the pocket.
Eighth Nevada penalty. Play fake. Looking back. He's got a blocker. Jackson. Stepping out right near the two, close to the first down. Let's see where they spot it.
This is a throwback screen. They do a great job of setting up, and he lets the blocking get in front. It's a great job, great patience by him. It's going to be interesting to see where this ball is spotted. Looks like it's fourth down. Big play. And I'm going to guess they run the ball here.
He's about a yard short. Fourth and one. Nevada going for it at the Washington State 3-yard line. Jackson. Does he have enough? The spot will be key.
We can't really tell where the ball was. It looks like, according to our line, that the ball, he probably reached it, but we'll have to see. I think they're going to measure this. Hard to tell, because even if you looked at this from the camera angles, I'm not sure you could tell where the ball went down. It was in the middle of the pile.
Huge measurement coming right here early in this fourth quarter.
Two gambling coaches. Maybe Pullian has a little swashbuckle on him too.
Now almost the length of the football. First and goal, Nevada.
Brian Pullian, if they end up winning this game, is going to get what he wants out of it. He's proved that they have an identity and that they can run the ball against anyone, and that they will run the ball anywhere on the field, any down and distance.
14th play of this drive upcoming for Nevada. First and goal from the two.
I think
prior to the timeout, the previous play is under further review. The ruling on the field is a first down.
So they're going to take a look at it, and while they do, we'll step aside here in Reno. Well, the play was reviewed. The call stands. We'll take another peek at it here shortly, but nonetheless, it is a first and goal for Nevada at the 2-yard line of Washington State. Jackson flips into the end zone, touchdown, Wolfpack.
They stayed true to their identity. They kept that ball on the ground. 13 rushes, only one pass play that entire drive. Gotta please Coach Pullian.
And all the looks that we had of the spot, there was certainly not enough video evidence to overturn the call for replay official David Dumas. And it results in a 14-play Nevada scoring drive. And Zuzo's extra point attempt. 21-10. Nevada. Well, the play that was reviewed was the fourth down play. The carry by Jackson. When the elbow comes down, now he's down. But you see where the football is. The elbow's down.
Yeah, you can't really tell. Where is the ball when that elbow goes down? But it's a huge call and a huge play, because the very next play is the touchdown.
He almost lost that football.
Yeah, he was going to get in there, but he almost got there without the ball.
So the second touchdown run of the game for Don Jackson. And the first points for Nevada since a Butler one-yard touchdown run about 3 minutes into the second quarter.
And I guarantee you, there's no relaxing on the Nevada sideline, though. 11 points for this Washington State team with Mike Leach calling plays and Connor Halliday cutting it loose. They just have to continue to play great defense. And if they do get the ball back, they've got to think about running time off the clock. And the best way to do that is run the ball as they've done.
And Nevada touchdown, the first points for either team so far here in the second half, as Washington State has missed a couple of field goal attempts. From the five, Morrow. Nice return for Washington State. Morrow all the way out to the 40. 36-yard return. Well, the first ever meeting between Virginia Tech and Ohio State. ESPN College Football Primetime presented by Hampton Hotels. ESPN Saturday at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Ohio State has won 25 straight regular season games. That's the longest active streak in the nation.
Bigger for the ACC or the Big Ten? What do you think?
I think Big Ten.
I think so, too.
Galvin to the 46.
And Washington State is going to continue to do what they do, throw the wide screens, believe that they can outrun people in space or make people miss. And for Nevada, they have to tackle. They've got a gang tackle, pursuit of the ball.
Bailey, the receiver at the top of the screen. Leaping catch from Bailey, who lunges forward to the 34-yard line, brought down by Nigel Hakins, first down.
Maley, absolutely no fear. He knows there's a safety in there, goes up for the pass. Connor Halliday, no fear, because he's got Maley to throw the ball to.
Now Washington State marching down the field, first down at the 34, Nevada. Give it to West. Darren West for the 27. Tackled there by defensive end Dupree Roberts Jordan.
Washington State ahead of the chains. The difficult decision for Nevada. Coverage or pressure? Coverage or pressure? And then for Washington State, it's recognition of what they decide.
Halliday to the near side. At the 20-yard line, the completion to Isaiah Myers. Another first down.
He knows right where he's going with the ball. Perfect throw despite the coverage. They've got to find, Nevada has to find a way to make him uncomfortable in the pocket. Right now, he's too comfortable.
They stack three receivers up top. Halliday hands it off to West. To the 16, gains three or four. Tackled there by Hecking.
The draw play is a great equalizer, a great neutralizer of pass rush. If you're getting too much of a pass rush from the defensive line, you call the draw to neutralize their pass rush.
Bailey back in at the top of your screen. Galvin in the slot up on the top side. Halliday fires a bullet incomplete at the three. The coverage there for Charles Garrett.
A lot of contact between those two. They're bumping each other right off the line. Got away with one, maybe that backside.
Showing blitz, flag, pre-snap.
No contact was made. I believe that is probably going to go against Washington State.
False start, offense, number 58, 5-yard penalty, third down.
The center, Riley Sorensen, called for the penalty, the ninth Cougars penalty. It's going to push it back to the 21 and make it third and 12. Still think it's four down territory here?
I do. And where's Maley? I'm going his way. I'm going his way with his man in zone.
Maley not in there on that package. Well, the receiver stopped short. That was Galvin. He had lane covering.
It was a great job because the defense disguised enough it created confusion in the mind of the quarterback and the receiver as to what they should do.
Well, Eric Powell has missed from 35 and 38 yards in this half. You'd be looking at a similar attempt here. And Mike Leach is going to give Quentin Brashears an opportunity. This will be his first field goal attempt 38-yard attempt for Quentin Brashears. Plenty of leg and knocks it through. Washington State may have a new place kicker.
Yeah, and they make it now a one-possession ball game. It'll force Washington State to have to go for two, which is always exciting.
ESPN College Football Primetime is presented by Jimmy John's Freaky Fast Delivery and in part by Voya Financial, changing the way you think of retirement.
Thanks for staying up late with us in Reno. It's a good town to stay up late if you so choose. 21-13, Nevada leading Washington State here in the fourth quarter. Both offense started off a little slowly. Cody Fajardo with his 55-yard run. It was over 10,000 yards of total offense, third player in Nevada history to do so. Butler with a touchdown run. Made it 14-0 Nevada, but Washington State comes back. Touchdown catch there for Maley. It is 14-7. Washington State has missed two field goals in the third quarter. Go to Quentin Brashears, who kicked the 38-yard field goal to make this an 8-point game. Mitchell back deep, along with Kendall Brock. Now Mitchell is not going to return that. Nevada will begin from the 20 with 9.5 minutes still to play. Which, in Washington State terms, 9.5 minutes can seem like days for what their offense can do in that amount of time.
Absolutely true. I will tell you this. The best defense for Nevada is to stay on the field with their offense, not let the Washington State team back on the field, because they are so explosive. And as we've talked about, when Halliday gets in a rhythm, he probably gets that look in his eye. He knows where he's going to go before the ball is even snapped. And his receivers have been backing him up. So they've got to do a good job here. One, it'd be nice for them to put a scoring drive together and take time off the clock.
Jardo keeping. An incompletion at the 33, looking for Richie Turner. And a Washington State player is injured.
I think he's got a cramp. I can see him saying, hey, help me out here. I'm cramping up a little bit. Is it Charleston White?
Looks I think? Yeah, the field cornerback, yeah. Charleston White, redshirt freshman out of Amarillo, Texas.
He did a great job of breaking on that ball to break up that pass play. They're not giving a lot of room to Nevada's receivers. Comes up right there and says, hey, wait a second, something's wrong. I need a little help here. Don't call another play yet.
Walking a little better as he gets closer to his own sideline here on the near side. This is the third ever meeting between these schools. Washington State won the previous two. The last time they met was back in 2005. Mike Leach has won here. He brought Texas Tech here in 2008.
He talked about it. I told him it's a tough place to play. He said he knows. He's been here before.
And Fajardo with a first down run up to the 38-yard line. Gain of 13.
He's so quick. Like the coaches say, he is faster than you think. He does a great job on the read right here. The interior tackle tackles the back, which opens up a huge lane for Fajardo.
Butler tripped up at the 41 for a gain of 3. Now Butler's hobbling off. Little hitch in that giddy up.
You know, Fajardo was walking a little gingerly back to the huddle, too. So, you know, when you carry the ball like that, he's going to get dinged a little bit.
But the past years, he's gotten dinged a lot. And the key for Nevada is, and he doesn't get dinged a lot this year. Hold it out of Jackson's belly on that zone read to the 46, leaving him 2 yards shy of the first down. It's going to bring up a third and short, third and two.
They're making a living on that play, and we can just watch it right here. Watch his eyes. Watch him. Watch the eyes of the defensive lineman. Follows behind the blocking of the line. He's trying to make that. It's first down, touchdown, or get down.
So they've converted on both their third and shorts, third and two or less, but overall 4 of 13 on third down. Butler is back in as the back. Fajardo finds the tight end. First catch of the night for Jared Gibson, and a Wolfpack first down after a gain of five.
Nice throw. Had him open earlier. Didn't quite get it there, but really nice throw. Nice timing on this. Gets the necessary yardage for the first down. Keeps the drive alive, which may be the most important thing right now.
It keeps the clock running. Mike, I would assume if you're Nevada, you want to shorten this game.
Absolutely. There's no question about it. They don't want to give Washington State the ball back with any appreciable time. They'd like to get a score out of it, too. I don't want to be too greedy, though.
Butler. I think the turf made the tackle on that one. He loses a yard.
He was trying to cut without his feet under him. He saw something and just was trying to bust it a little too quick.
Send Henderson in motion. Fajardo keeping. Tackled hard at the 48 for a gain of three. Stapled down there by Mitchell Peterson.
They're taking a little bit more time in between plays on this drive, too. So they're trying to extend it by snapping the ball, you know, with 10 to 15 seconds left instead of 20 or 30. They're milking the clock a little bit right now between snaps.
With eight on the play clock there. Fajardo throws a strike to Henderson. And a Nevada first down at the Washington State 25. But Henderson slow to get up.
We talk about the range, the big receiver. Here's the pressure coming. Fajardo does a nice job. The line picks it up. He puts the ball right on the money. Henderson goes up a 6'5 to start with, but look at him leap into the air. That's great range. That's a guy you want to throw the ball to. Unfortunately, landed a little bit wrong. He would be a bad guy for them to miss tonight because he's been a big target for Fajardo.
Well, they attend to Hassan Henderson. We'll step aside as well here in Reno. Hassan Henderson off slowly, but off under his own power. 6:26 to play in the fourth quarter. His 21-yard catch for Henderson at a first down. And as soon as he came down, he immediately showed that he was shaken up. One left, Butler. Out just inside the 20.
They need Henderson, though. He's a big play guy. He's a difference maker for them going against that Washington State secondary. When they needed the big pass play, he's been the guy that Fajardo was throwing the ball to. Hopefully, he can get back in the game.
Clock running here. 2 points of order for Nevada, really, Mike, I would think. Any kind of points here for Nevada makes this a two-possession game.
Absolutely right. They need to get some kind of points on the board. And obviously, Washington State needs to stop that.
This is Butler straight ahead. Setting up another third and short after a gain of two. Fajardo has completed his last four third down passes if they elect to put it in the air here.
Washington State substituted almost the entire front line right there. Those guys get beat down a little bit. They want some fresh bodies in. They need a stand right here.
Turner trying to make a move. He still needs to reach the 18 for a first down. Now he's coming back towards the near side and is tackled at the 22 for a loss. Well, a lot going on that play, but the end result for Washington State is positive as he was eventually able to be run down by Tracy Clark.
He ran about 50 yards. This is a reverse. You see the fake there going to toss him to the back. Great cutback block. I don't think he can block below the waist right there, but nice job, and then great pursuit by Washington State. They just continue, gets a couple other comeback blocks. Big tackle, he ran about 40 yards to lose four.
So Brent Zuzo comes on to attempt his first field goal of the night. First field goal attempt of the year. He was 14 to 17 last year. This is a 40-yard attempt. And had that counted, would have been good, but no.
Before the snap, timeout, Nevada, their first of the half.
Oh, Nevada called it.
Yeah, and I think Coach wanted to talk a little bit either about protection or something, but I think he's a little bit sad now that he might have called that timeout. Taking points off the board is no fun.
Forty-yard field goal attempt coming here for Brent Zuzo to try to make this a two-possession lead for Nevada with 4:29 to play. He had hit the 40-yarder, but time was called by Nevada. And he makes it a moot point. Well, Nevada head coach Brian Polian told us yesterday, hey, I'm comfortable with Zuzo here at home from 55 yards and in. And I say at home because remember, we're at 4,600 feet elevation. So the ball does travel a little further here in this light air.
It does, but you still got to put it down the middle of the uprights. And that wasn't a great snap. That was a great hold. And you're looking at going as a coach, oh my gosh, I took points off the board. We better make this. I'm putting the pressure on my players.
Do give credit to Braden Sanchez, who's also their punter. And a wide receiver, but holding there did a nice job on what wasn't the greatest snap and does make it a 24-13 game. But 4:25 to play for Washington State's offense, that's a lot of time.
It is, but now time becomes an issue here. And like I said, it's a lot of time. It's really how good a defense can Nevada play? How quickly can Washington State mount a scoring drive and then find a way to get the ball back?
Two timeouts for Washington State, which they obviously would prefer to spend on defense after scoring.
The other thing, if Washington State scores, do they go for two to set up a chance for a field goal to tie? That's the other thing to think about. So
the field goal hasn't been their best friend tonight is with the two misses, though perhaps with Brashears hitting his only attempt, he would get an opportunity if it came down to that.
Yeah, I think he would based on what's happened tonight.
Take it from the 15. Good starting field position up to the 34. Of course, Brian Polian, who's just 39 years old. He's the sixth youngest head coach in the Football Bowl subdivision. And yes, is the son of our own colleague at ESPN, Bill Polian.
He looks younger than 39, but he sounds older. His voice has aged a little bit in the last couple of years.
Now in his second season here in Reno as the University of Nevada head coach, he says, hey, it's year two. I'm much more comfortable than year one.
Yeah, he's more comfortable with who he is and how he coaches, and the players are more comfortable with him.
Holiday dumps off the screen to the back, Theron West. Gains about six on first down, met by Ian Seau. There's Seau, who is the nephew, the late junior Seau.
Washington State is going to be in their hurry-up mode. Get out of bounds, first down or touchdown. Nevada has to tackle in space.
Pass behind Galvin, and a chance to be picked off there by Brian Lane.
If he could have climbed a little higher on that ladder, he'd have had that one. Once again, Halliday just throwing to a spot, assuming his receiver's going to be there. Not quite on the same page.
Halliday has been picked twice. Bailey is the receiver at the top of the screen. Maybe some confusion there between Galvin and Bailey. They were setting up the wide receiver screen, but who was supposed to receive the pass?
I think actually they were both running slant routes and they didn't know who he was throwing the ball to. He floated that ball a little bit. This is obviously four down territory. There's no question about it at this point in the game. Might have been anyway, but this is a huge play and obviously both sides want to win it. You got to play tight coverage because you only need 4 yards.
Bailey and Galvin again, the receivers at the top of the screen, and they hand it off, and he winds up short. Jamal Morrow.
Wow.
Brock Hecking, number 53, the first to stop his momentum, and he definitely came up about a yard short.
Well, there's no question. Hecking coming off the edge right there makes a sure tackle. And that, I'm actually surprised. I did not think they would run it on fourth and four right there, and that they had chances to throw the ball. But I think they felt like they could catch the defense off guard, get those guys coming to pass rush. But tremendous play by a tremendous player, a guy that is an all-league player at this level, one of the best players they have, and the best players you have make plays at the right time.
You know, when we chatted yesterday with Brock Hecking at their practice, we said, hey, when a Pac-12 team, you get a chance to play a Pac-12 team, is it a big deal? He didn't hesitate. He said, absolutely.
No question. He wants to do it on a big stage. We talked about already, but there he is in full glory. Business up front, but big-time party in the back.
The front took over on that last play because he was all business. Now the clock does become the enemy of Washington State, and Nevada trying to eat up as much of that clock as they can.
They're going to run the football. They're going to take time off between plays. And there, yeah. And he does say that he does know who Brian Bosworth is. He didn't really give Hulk Hogan much credit when I asked him.
Yeah, he said the haircut was definitely the boss.
Yeah. All right. Defense got to come up with something right here. Washington State.
Got outside. Jackson got in the air and came down hard at the 39.
Smart play. That's well coached because he could have let himself be pushed out of bounds, jumped up, made sure he stayed in bounds, keep the clock moving.
So Washington State will use one of their last two timeouts. So they have one remaining with 2:53 to go.
Obviously, when you're in this situation, the coaches are telling them the first guy tackle the ball, carry, hold him up. The second and third guys rip and strip the ball.
Stanford puts the nation's longest home winning streak on the line. Saturday afternoon football on ABC, 14th-ranked USC and 13th-ranked Stanford, 3:30 Eastern, 12:30 Pacific, out here on the West Coast. So that's 13 against 14. Take a look at the top teams. Florida State, an unimpressive win. Is that the best way against Oklahoma State, have the Citadel, and then how about Oregon taking on Michigan State?
Big game for both conferences, big game for both teams. The speed, the tempo of Oregon versus the toughness and the physical nature of Michigan State. Should be a great game.
Third down at 5.
Where are we up?
And Washington State has one timeout remaining. Fajardo keeping. A couple yards shy of the first down, and Washington State used their final timeout to stop it with 2:46 to play.
Same play they've been running that he's been very successful. The defense played it better that time for Washington State. Still got some serious yards, but fourth and two here. You know, I don't know Coach Pulliam well enough to say we're going to run it on fourth down and win the game right here, or we're going to punt it down and play defense. Based on what I saw at the end of the first half, I'd say he'd punt it down, play defense, and rely on his defense to help win this game.
When this game does come to a conclusion, we'll send you to Sports Center. That's coming up next. And this, of course, the first year for the college football playoff. It will be the final four teams remaining. That will be the top four in the seeded semifinal. Semifinals rotating each year. And of course, the championship game will be January 12th in Arlington, Texas at AT&T Stadium. They're going to go for it on fourth and one. Pre-snap whistle. Boy, a penalty against Washington State. Could very well, for all intents and purposes, in this game.
Illegal substitution. Defense, 12 players lined up in the formation. That 5-yard penalty results in a first down.
Coach Leach and the entire coaching staff, especially on defense, will not be very happy about that. You don't even give players a chance to try to win this game.
So the 10th Washington State penalty tonight gives Nevada a first down. Washington State, no timeouts remaining at 2:45 to go. Nevada looks to run out the clock and take home a win at home against the Pac-12 team.
Yeah.
25 goes down Jackson.
I don't have my table with me, but pretty soon they're going to be able to take a knee at 40 seconds a pop in between. So it'll be interesting. They still have to be worried about ball security. You got to protect the football on the snap and when you get tackled.
Tackled at the 23. We're under 2 minutes to go. Stopped there by Mitchell Peterson.
Mitchell Peterson had 16 tackles last week in the game. He said he surprised the entire team, but he just showed up everywhere. That was a huge tackle, because had he missed that tackle, the guy cut back, he was going for a long ways.
Well, just computing the time right now, if they stop him, they could get the ball back, but with only about a half minute left on the clock.
Any time is better than none.
A tackle to the backfield. Jackson dropped for a loss by, guess who? Mitchell Peterson.
Came off the edge unblocked. You got to protect the edges when you get in your 4 minute offense. This is when you want to run out the clock. But certainly right now, they're going to let this thing go down all the way.
Nevada has two timeouts. They could use one of those. The play clock gets down to one.
Yeah, I think they will do that and then decide whether they want to punt it, pooch kick it, run the ball, just take as much time off the clock as possible. Maybe they'll do a pooch punt from an offensive formation.
Timeout, Nevada. Their second of the half.
Well, a big weekend. We may look back here at week two when we do get to this college football playoff and say, hey, week two was a big week for determining some of these four teams they're going to make it. Now, the difference is obviously between the BCS, which ended after last year, and this college football playoff, a four-team playoff with the rotation of the six bowls and the championship. Year one of this college football playoff again is at the Metroplex in Arlington, Texas.
Yeah, the biggest difference for me is that selection method. Bowls and rankings versus selection committee. The 13-person committee brings the human element to it. They're going to look at who's a conference.
Just 37 seconds remaining. Fajardo keeping. And when he's whistled down, the clock will stop on the change of possession. So Washington State get the football back at about their own 26-yard line with no timeouts left and 32 seconds to go and down by two scores.
Stranger things have happened. In 1971, UC Davis was down 15 points, actually, to Cal State Hayward, and they came back and scored 16 points in 20 seconds to win the game. So stay tuned. Amazing things can happen.
And I know there's a good reason why you remember that.
Well, I played on that, on the Davis team that won. So I always, when I was coaching, I always said, you're never out of it. It's never over till it's over.
Thanks, Yogi. Maley needs to get out of bounds. He took a couple of defenders with him. It's a big body to bring down, Vince Maley, at 6'3", 220.
It's a big body, and obviously they're trying to preserve the clock. Nevada has to try to tackle people inbounds and not give up the big play. Nothing behind you. Notice the safeties are 25 yards deep plus.
Halliday, he tried to shovel it out of bounds or what the situation was there, but a penalty flag comes out, and Halliday slow to get up there on the Nevada sideline.
I think that was a late hit. That's any way you pass it. He was just trying to save yardage, stop the clock.
That's Seau chasing him. And Ryan Polian is
a little bit fired up. What
yes.
do you think?
Well, you can see Seau trying to knock the ball out with that swipe of the arm, but it looked like the ball had already come out.
I'm not sure what. Yeah. See what happened though. They definitely threw a penalty, and we're gonna get.
It was over. Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Defense number 8. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
That's a teaching moment. You cannot do that when a guy's going out of bounds, no matter how close you are. Discretion, the better part of valor. Don't help them at this point in the game.
Yeah, let's see, the ball had come out.
Ball had come out. He'd already tossed it away, so he's like a passer who's protected at that point.
I'll be honest, I didn't see a whole lot there, though.
No. As we talked about, safety's back. The deep safeties are 20 to 25, maybe even 30 yards. Keep everything underneath you.
Holiday fires underneath at the 30. Fighting his way forward is Isaiah Myers. They'll stop the clock to move the chains with 13 seconds left, first down.
I thought that was going to be the hook and ladder, or hook and lateral. Looked like the other receiver was going to come behind him.
Holiday to the sideline. Stepping out is Morrow, the back, with just 2 seconds left. And they're at the 13-yard line, so time for one more play.
Yeah, I don't think the magic is going to happen now. I've never seen it done in 2 seconds.
So Nevada is going to beat a Pac-12 team at home. The first time since they beat Cal here in 2010. Final play of the game. And the final tackle made by Lenny Jones, and Nevada wins it 24-13.
Congratulations to Coach Pulleyan and the Nevada Wolfpack. That's a great game. Washington State contributed to its own demise, but they controlled the football by running it.
Nevada improves to 2-0. Washington State drops to 0-2. Fun game here in Reno tonight. Sports Center coming your way next. For Shelly Smith and Coach Mike Bellotti and our entire crew, I'm Mark Neely. Thanks for sharing this one. 24-13, Nevada beats Washington State. Now let's city to Sports Center. Good night from Reno.